What's going on, everyone? NoZoupForYou here, and I have some more ranked gameplay, because it's ranked, and that's what everybody's playing right now, and I'm sure everybody is scrambling to find that one ship, that one magic bullet, that ship that just works for you, and helps you win every game, and cruise effortlessly to rank one, and I don't think that ship exists, I really don't. The law of averages says that, you're going to take some hits along the way, like I did right there against that Odin, but that's okay. I am playing in the Bayard right now, and I love the Bayard. I think the Bayard is one of the best Tier 8 ships in the game. In fact, it might be one of the best cruisers in the game. I don't know, that's a little debatable. Definitely at Tier 8, though. Definitely at Tier 8. Off to a little bit of a rocky start right now, though. I took a little hit, and that's one of the big negatives about the Bayard. The Bayard is pretty much a glass hull. If you're sneezed on, you're going to take damage, which is basically what happened right there. Except I wasn't sneezed on by bodily fluid. I was sneezed on by Odin guns, which I think those hurt a lot more than a regular sneeze. But this round in particular, I really happened to enjoy because I had one of those clutch rounds that everybody hopes for. Those rounds where you save defeat from victory, or no, we don't like that, do we? That happens way too much. Save victory from defeat. Save victory from defeat. That's what I want to say. I'm so used to saying the other thing because that's usually how it works in ranked gameplay, but not this time. Not this time. But this is a compelling argument. This round is a compelling argument, or at least the very end of this round, for why the Bayard is such a good ship and how it can be used to really just take control of the game. Now, in the early stages of the round right now, I'm just doing what I like doing in very fast ships. I'm just flying around the map and trying to put ships on fire and harass the enemy. Right now, not really good shape on this left side. I've only got two other ships with me, two battleships, granted, which is kind of nice. But the bulk of the team decided to go to sea, which, you know, it's a plan. That's what everybody decided to do, so I just went with it. You know, some rounds I try to get my way with where we go, but other times I just, you know, whoever says something first, I'm like, okay, and go on. I'm not one of those people that fights it. When people decide they want to go somewhere, or when someone makes a plan. If someone's bold enough to make a plan, I go with it. Sometimes that runs into a little bit of trouble when you know the plan's going to be a disaster, but that is what it is. You can see right now, finally got a fire on a ship, got a fire on the, I think it was the Massachusetts just now, and I'm just going to continue working on them because I don't want them pushing up on B. And the Bayard really excels when you have open water where you can utilize its speed. And, you know, obviously the speed is one of the best things about this ship, aside from its guns, its HE reload, and its ability to just sling lead at the enemy. So I'm doing what I normally do right now in this type of ship. You know, it's pretty much kind of like a Kabbie or something like that. I'm just flying around the map, high speed, trying to dodge the enemy if they decide to fire at me, trying to set them on fire, and one of my battleships has already been sunk, destroyer's been sunk, the other battleship's on the run, I'm on the run, I don't have the firepower myself to take on this Massachusetts and this Odin, and I'm kind of worried about my friendly battleship here, so I'm going to do what I can and set these fires, which I'm doing right now, which I'm having moderate success at that. But, you know, it's not going to be enough to stop this push right here. So, another thing about this round that I realized when I got done playing, actually when I went to play the Bayard again, I forgot to put modules on this ship. I completely forgot to put modules on it, so I don't know when the last time I played this ship was. That's some good damage right there, actually, 3,000. Another fire, and that's the nice thing about this ship. You can get some good damage with your HE. But yeah, I forgot completely to put modules on this ship. And I have since rectified that. I'm actually running double rudder shift on it, which I seem to like in this ship because it gives you that maneuverability and the ability to dodge shells. But you can see right now I've lost another battleship right there. We don't have the point lead. We've got one cap. The enemy is about to get two caps. And I'm just kind of loitering around right here, see if I can get a lucky torp strike as these battleships come around the side of this island. But I don't know that that's going to happen or not. Really, that's just me trying to get lucky. And the way this round's been going so far, I don't know that I'm going to have that type of luck. My teammates were fighting over at sea, though. Destroyer's been pushed out. Managed to sink their destroyer right now. So once again, things are evened up. I mean, it's a pretty close battle. They've got a low health Cleveland. I'm slowly starting to make my way to sea because I think that's the thing to do right now. I can't do anything at B. I just can't. I don't have the type of firepower to deal with two battleships. Maybe one I could, just dancing around and being clever. But that destroyer's out there somewhere spotting me. These battleships are lurking. I thought they were going to go the long way around, but they decided to turn back and cut through B, which, you know, that makes sense. I'd do that too, and they're starting to fire at me right now, and they're pretty close, which concerns me. But I've got speed maneuverability on my side, so I'm just going to keep raining shells on them if I can, and my shell reload booster is about to come back up. There's a fire right there, so I'm going to focus on the Odin now, try and set a fire on him. Now that I've got one on the Massachusetts, though, he just put that out. You can see Benson's lurking right there. He's still around. Cleveland's back there. He's still around as well. Our kid's going to push in, try and do what he can, though I don't know that there's much he can do. Right now, we don't even have C. Our battleship has not made it there yet. We are bleeding points. We might have the same amount of ships, but we definitely do not have the same amount of points anymore. And this lead is only going to widen for them. I'm just trying to get into open water, stay as flat to these ships as I can so they can't peg me on the side, on the broadside, which would suck. But their Benson is making a mistake right now. He's coming into play, though my own teammate Smoke is obscuring him. That happens. I don't blame him for that. He's trying to cover himself. We just lost our Baltimore now, so we're down both points and ships. Four ships to three, and they have a good 200-point lead over us. We're about to lose our kid. I'm working furiously on this Odin trying to sink him. There goes our kid, so now it's four ships to two. And things are not looking good at all. 700 points to 350. How are we going to win this? I don't know. It's up to this battleship and myself. There goes the Odin. That's a good thing right there. Massachusetts helped out right there. So that's nice. Got a fire on the Massachusetts right there. Once again, I'm worried that he's going to focus on me, and he should have. He should not have worried about our battleship yet. I mean, he's got the hit points where he could take care of that later on. I am the bigger threat right now, and the fact that he has not realized that is going to help me out a lot. He should have stayed bow into that enemy battleship and focused on me, because I'm ripe for the picking. I'm close, I'm within his wheelhouse, and at this point, you know, with a ship like the Bayard, any shells he lands on me are going to hurt. Any shells are going to hurt, but he's not focusing on me, and I'm just staying outside of his secondary range, though I'm going to kind of push in right now because I see that he's not focused on me. He doesn't care about me whatsoever. He's not moving his guns toward me, so this is giving me some very bold ideas. I'm thinking to myself, hey, I might even get in torp range. I'm going to push in. I still don't see those turrets slewing towards me. If I did, I would bug out in an instant. But they're not. And actually, he's turning in towards our Massachusetts. Right here, he could have ended this round. Right here, he could have ended it. But he's still going after that Massachusetts instead of me, which I've still got a decent amount of health, but I don't have heals. I don't have heals at all. And he's going to be going down here pretty soon. Tactical error on his part. He should have gone for me, but he didn't, and you know what? That's going to work out to our advantage here in a second. We're still losing significantly. 736, 740 hit points. We just lost our Massachusetts right there. It's now 1-on-2. 788 points to 370. Things are not looking good, though I'm spotted. And the fact that I'm spotted tells me that there is a chance. There's a chance that I can at least find the destroyer. And if I can sink the destroyer, I might be able to move on, stop the bleed somewhere, or take out the enemy cruiser. I know there's hope right now. I know there's not a lot of hope. If I was the enemy right now, I would be moving as far away from me as possible. I would be going to either A1, J1, somewhere where I am not, because I have the speed to chase down just about everything at Tier 8. Save for the fastest destroyers out there. And look at that. Lo and behold, I have been spotted. Mr. Benson has made a pretty critical mistake right here, and so has Cleveland. I don't know what Cleveland was doing. He's just stopped right there. He's backing up. So I'm going to forget about the Benson for a second, because look at this. Look at that. One salvo, he's gone. Get my high caliber right there. And now we have hope. 6 minutes left in the round, and I'm not even worried about points at this point. I am just worried about chasing down this Benson and destroying him. Because if I do that, it's game over. And it's a clutch victory. And he's going to try and do some WASD hacks. He's going to try and wiggle his way out. But at this point, there's not much he can do. I'm steaming forward at 41 knots. He can't escape me. And he doesn't. And I win clutch. And this was an enjoyable round. And the Bayard is a great ship. So if you're thinking about using it for ranked, give it a try. I'm not saying it's perfect for ranked, but it's good fun. And it's my type of fun. And with that type of fun, you can enjoy the game. And that's what it's all about, right? Enjoying the game. So anyhow, thanks for watching. Tell me what your favorite ships are in ranked right now. I am interested to know. I will catch you all later. Zoop out.